shot, but we've had a problem for years with North Korea. In fact, President Obama said it was the biggest problem we had. And South Korea went there. We put very, very strong sanctions and lots of other things we've been doing right from the first day I was in office. And South Korea came to my office after having gone to North Korea and seeing Kim Jong-un. And it's very positive. After the meeting, you may do that, but now we have to be very nice, because let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. So the South Korean top people, top representatives, they walked out the White House to a throng of these characters. Big, big group. And everybody wanted to find out what happened. Now, they had just left North Korea. Look, North Korea is tough. They're testing nuclear weapons. They're doing a lot of things. This should have been handled, by the way, over the last 30 years, not now. That's a good job. This should have been handled, and everybody will say it, too. But that's okay, because that's what we do. We handle things. And these guys came out, and they said that your president's done a great job, I might say. Well, I'll tell you, we did a great job in the Olympics. President Moon of South Korea said, without Donald Trump, the Olympics would have been a total failure. Might as well say it. Nobody else is going to say it. A little hard to sell tickets when you think you're going to be nuked. But when North Korea called and they said, we'd like to be in the Olympics, everybody said, let's buy tickets, let's go. I would have gone. And it became a very, very successful Olympics. Honestly, South Korea did a great job, and it was great to see North Korea going and participating. And it was a nice unity. It was really a nice... But when the South Korean representatives who just left North Korea came outside, big throng of press, they announced that North Korea, Kim Jong-un, would like to meet with President Trump. This doesn't happen. You know, they're saying, oh, well, Obama could have done that, trust me. He would not have done it. And by the way, neither would Bush and neither would Clinton. And they had their shot, and all they did was nothing. Clinton gave away billions and billions of dollars. And as soon as they made the deal, the following day, they started working on making more nukes, okay? So that's not the great one. You ever see the story where it's 1999, I'm on Meet the Press, a show now headed by Sleepy Eyes Chuck Todd. He's a sleeping son of a bitch, I'll tell you. Morning, 1999, and I'm talking about North Korea. You got to take them out now. And then they have Clinton saying, we are pleased to announce that we have made a deal with North Korea. Well, you know how that deal turned out, right? We gave billions and billions of dollars and lots of other things, and we got nothing. But they show me, young, handsome. I said, why couldn't I look like that today? I should have run back then, right? I should have run back then. I would have done this earlier. But they had me literally saying, I don't know if anybody saw it, they played a lot, but literally saying, to a very good guy, actually, but saying that we're going to do something about North Korea. That was when it wasn't involved. And then they have Clinton giving everything away, and then they show, and here we are today, with a man who's nuked up all over the place. But we've been very strong and very vigilant, and now lots of good things I think are going to happen, but we'll see. But the funny thing, so they announced that he's not going to send missiles up anymore until through the meetings. Well, think of that. You know, we were losing, we were getting a lot of missiles sent. I wouldn't say Japan was thrilled. Missiles flying over Japan. They're very happy with what I'm doing. And who else could do it? I mean, honestly, when you think. They're not going to send missiles up. Think of it. They're not sending missiles up. And I believe that. I believe that. I really do. I think they want to do something. I think they want to make peace. I think it's time. And I think we've shown great strength. I think that's also important. And I must tell you, President Xi of China has really helped us a lot. They've really helped us. And because 93% of the goods come in through China going into Korea, North Korea. 93%, so that's pretty powerful. And they've been very good. They could have done more, but that's okay. I say no, you've been great. You could do more, but they've done a lot. They've done more, China has done more for us than they have ever done for any other president or ever done for this country, and I respect that. Stopping the flow of goods, very important. And we put sanctions on. So they come out, White House, many of these same characters, and I see those faces. I see those faces. And for the first 2 hours, it was unbelievable. This is amazing. This is incredible. I can't believe this is happening. You know, because we go from, like, look, a lot of people thought we were going to war. And all of a sudden they come in, they say, we're going to have a meeting, and there's no more missiles going off, and they want to denuclearize. Nobody had heard that. Nobody thought, but they said they wanted, they were thinking about that. Who knows what's going to happen? Hey, who knows? It happens, and it doesn't happen. We may leave fast, or we may sit down and make the greatest deal for the world and for all of these countries, including, frankly, North.
So fake. Fake news.